Hello and welcome to the Major League Tagpro Top 10. My name is Canadian, and I'll be your host for the Week 6 edition of the show. As always, let's get started with some honorable mentions. With TPR past 3 and only leg man in base, the latter is forced to grab, makes a sneaky escape bottom, and brings the flag all the way back for a 30 seconds counter cap. As Alvin brings the flag into base, he is separated from his Tagpro lead. He comes in bottom and takes his time staying safe behind his teammates as they draw out a couple of flaccid grabs. Then he gets into action, slipping between Beal and Dalek for the cap. At number 10, we've got Espeluznante and Romulus, the latter trying to help with a tag bro. He first gets rid of Crippy, but his pursuit of Walrus's rolling bomb allows for enough time for a respawn. This time, Romulus takes them both out, as Espeluznante boosts off the corner and off the bottom wall, which gives him just the right angle to boost two past everyone for the score. We've got a familiar face at number 9. Romulus is going to grab the flag on an empty base and boost through the spikes with no hesitation past 4 for a Merball's cap. Got a similar play at number 8. Helen Keller is going to grab and get past the defense bottom. But with total confidence, Manbear takes the boost through the spikes for the fancy return. Great job. Number 7 features Swerve, who goes flag pro with little time remaining in the half. He makes his way top with myself closing in from behind. With a subtle move and Jet 2's block, he splits Cam Watson's soul for a cap as time expires. Great job, Swerve. At number 6, we've got Legman, who's going to take the flag bottom and somehow get past Micro to enter base through the spikes as Stan gets the return to guarantee a cap. Watch again as he steals that boost from Micro in style. Great job. Number 5 is a truly heroic effort by Dalek23. With Monte bringing the flag to base, he puts his tag pro to use. He retreats to protect his FC, then pops the trailing Alvin, moves on to Spiller. Coys is next, and as Wayne looks to be out, he makes the return to allow the Monte score. Great job. Number 4 starts with a solid TPR block, allowing Maiko to get past 3. Jem and Knobler boost Legman out of the play, but he corners onto another boost and sends himself barreling into Micro, mere tiles away from a cap. Watch that again as he hits the corner and angles himself perfectly to get Micro. Matrix takes center stage at number 3. He forces Alvin to overcommit, gate-killing the Tag Pro and the FC. With only 2 in base, he grabs, takes advantage of an amazing block by Monte, and times his boost perfectly to split Alvin and Wayne for a role model's cap. Watch that again, as he just barely slips around the Tag Pro, killing 2. And very patiently waits for Monte to set up that fantastic block, just barely holding it long enough for him to get past everyone for the cap. At number 2, we've got the Major League debut of Honey Bear. As he comes into base top, he's going to boost off the corner and use that momentum to get past Yas, and then pixel between Bowtie and Helen Keller for a fantastic cap. Watch again just to see how very close that was. Great blocks by CC and Nelson to let him do it. And the number 1 play from the Week 6 edition of Major League Tagpro Top 10 comes from the role models. You'd think the Angry Balls would have learned not to chase Matrix with a Tagpro, as he slips past Coys and Spiller. For some reason, he brings the flag through 2, where Monte is forced to make another killer block on Alvin and Spiller. Dalek takes care of Coys, and that's another role model's cap. With blocks like these, Monte is really building a convincing case for best support O in the league. Great job. That puts an end to the Week 6 edition of the Major League Tagpro Top 10. Once again, my name is Canadian, and on behalf of everyone at Top 10 Plays, thanks for watching.